lion's den.
It always seems like it's situations that bring about the glass house type of situation, you know, where people, you know, feel they can, you know, throw all the stones and everything in a certain direction of whatever said individual, but then when it comes to themselves, you know, they forget that they live in a glass house of their own.
Well, you know, my mama always told me, she said, son, don't throw rocks if you live in a glass house. And what my mama was saying was basically, pointing the finger at somebody else. You got to remember, you got 3 points back at you.
Right.
Don't try to take a toothpick out of somebody else's eye when you need to take a long out of your own eye. So, a lot of times you got people who, as I say, you know, have hidden skeletons. And a lot of times, in order for them to address their skeletons, they attack others. They say negative things about other people, and they try to make the other people look like they so horrific and they're such a bad person. But reality, their reality is far more deep and far more gruesome and far more wicked than the person that they actually attacked. You know, people do that a lot. When you see a person constantly talking about other people, or a person constantly, you know, trying to shit on another person, it's a 99% chance that they live in a glass house. You know what I'm saying? And when people start throwing stones at them, it really be some stones. They really feel it because, you know, a person that got something to do or a person who have a life, they're not going to spend their time backbiting others. They're not going to spend their time slandering others. You know, one of the things that we used to teach in the moral science was you have two selves. The highest selves was the mothers of the virtues and the highest of life, and it bring justice, mercy, love, and right. But the lower self was what the highest self was not, and it bring hatred, slander, lewdness, murder, and theft. You know what I'm saying? So we slander other people, we're in our lower self. And a lot of times when people go to the lows and lows or to their lower self, what they're doing is they are trying to avoid, you know, anything to do with their higher self. Or they try to see somebody else that's in their higher self, somebody who have a peaceful mind, somebody who's doing something constructive, somebody who's trying to take care of their kids, run their business. They try to disrupt that. They try to cause confusion in the next man's life. You know, and the pains and the strains that it takes for us to cause confusion, it'd be just that much more easier for us to let the peace be still. You know, and a lot of people don't want to let the peace be still. But one thing that people got to understand, what goes wrong comes around. What goes up must come down. Right. You know what I'm saying? I have found that what goes around comes around. So, you know, we understand that the singer was basically saying that, you know, if you do something, you know what I'm saying, it's a 99% chance that it's going to come back on you. Not today, not tomorrow, maybe next year. Man, I remember I did some crazy stuff about 10 years prior to what happened to me. And so I'm riding, and the dude, you know, he kind of set me up. You know, wanted me to go somewhere, and I went there. As soon as I got there, I had a barrage of bullets hit my car, and I got hit 3 times with a 9mm. And I said, what did I do? You know, what did I do to merit this? I mean, I mind my own business. These folks trying to rob me, you know, and I thought about it. It said it must have been those things that I did in my past. You know, that caught up with me eventually. You know what I'm saying? And that's what happens when you do things and you got a past. You got to remember that your past will catch up with you. If you live in a glass house and you throw rocks, eventually somebody gonna throw rocks at your glass house and it's gonna shatter your glass. So, you know, we got to understand and we have to be very wise to understand that before you make an action, think about it, because the action does not lie in the actual action. The action lies in the thought. The thought was the cause of it all. You think about it before you do it. So sometimes you can give yourself 5 to 10 seconds to think about your actions before you actually act. You might be able to save yourself. You might be able to save yourself from a whole bunch of confusion, lust, and fuss, and all kind of other muss.
I was going to say, but now let's get more detail oriented, because I was thinking about this right when you were talking. You know, when you said if two people are yelling and arguing, you don't know who's the fool. Well, I look at it as in like football terminology. It's one that's always on the offense and the other's on the defense. How do you know really which side are you on? It's almost like which side are you on? Are you for the offense?
You know, a fool of all things, but it's on ignorance.
Yeah.
So if a fool is a fool, you can't rationalize with a fool. You know, you can tell a fool, hey man, don't do that, fool. And the fool gonna do it anyway.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? But a wise man thought it often. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he rationalized, you know, he, you know, I always tell you, you know what I'm saying, the difference between man and animal or man and reptile is that man has the ability to reason. You know, if I put a snake, I'll get this analogy again, if I put a snake in a cage, you ain't going in that cage to get that snake because you see that the cage is a trap.
Yeah.
But that lion, the hyena, the dog, all of them gonna go in that cage to get that snake. Because they don't have the ability to reason that that's a trap. If a lion was standing, and the lion is supposed to be one of the kings of the jungle, if he was standing in the midst of a pistol, if an ox was standing in the midst of a pistol, if a wild dog was standing in the midst of a pistol, the lion gonna roar, the ox gonna make noise, and the dog gonna bark. But neither one of them got enough sense to know that that bullet gonna blow their brains out.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, we have that ability to reason. So sometimes, you know, to separate yourself from the fool or separate the lion from the giant, you have to sit back and you have to think. That's what's going to separate you from the fool, is being able to think, I'm not going to do this because certain action always bring about certain reaction. You know what I'm saying? I used to always say that men are actors, women are reactors. A lot of times when women be tripping, it might be something that we just did. We just acted out. You know what I'm saying? So they reacted to our action.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So certain action bring about certain reaction. So a lot of times if you don't want to be caught up in the fool's, you know, court, you don't want to get caught up in the fool's quarrel, you know what I mean? Sometimes you just have to think about your actions and make different moves, you know what I mean? And sometimes somebody argue with you. Sometimes like, man, you right. You know what I'm saying? You win the argument, dude. I can't dispute what you're saying. You're absolutely right. And to walk away a wise man. You know, in the fool, he won't even have enough sense to know that you just played him.
I would say, too, you know, just like you said, you know, women act a certain way and men act a certain way, but it seems like a lot of so-called men out in place, instead of saying men, males want to act in female traits in place. You know, how they get all emotional about certain things.
Yeah, I mean, emotion is, I was taught as a young man, never let your emotions supersede your intelligence. You know, when you act on impulse and on emotions, it's almost inevitable that you're going to have a faulty result. So sometimes you just have to just, you know, don't have those hormones kick in, you know what I mean? And you get to act like a little bitch, you know what I'm saying? You know, sometimes you have to, you know, sit back and just analyze the situation and think it out. You know, because if you don't, man, you're going to always have those little bitch moments that we call, you know. Yeah. You know, like they say, he acting like a little bitch now. You know what I'm saying? You know, he acting all emotional. He all in his emotions. No man should ever want to be, you know, regarded in that manner. You know what I mean? Because, you know, we're supposed to be ones who keep our composure and keep our senses, you know, and keep our focus. So it's going to be individuals and people who do act in that capacity. Ain't nothing you can do about that. But those of us who are wise enough and intelligent enough to know that you're not supposed to act that way, then we need to act accordingly. Yeah, but you know, I mean, sometimes people, you know, they have hidden motives, they have agendas, and they act certain ways because I had a partner one time, man, we was at the event, and they gave me like $8,000 to come to the event. So naturally, I was the host of the party, so it was all about me. You know, I was the man, you know, I was the man of the opera, I was the host. And people were walking up to me, and they were giving me hugs, and, you know, they was complimenting me. And this dude, man, just got to acting a fool, acting a dummy. I'm like, what's wrong with this nigga? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, chill out, man. I ain't chilling out nothing, man. I don't like these dudes, man. I don't even know these people. I said, I don't even want to be here. I'm like, man, come on, man. Why you doing this? Oh, man, these folks paying me, man. They ain't gave me no money. And I looked at this sucker, man. I'm like, man, dude. Man, you better chill out, man. You know, but he wanted to get some shine at any cost. And he was willing to lose my friendship. He was willing to fight with me. He was willing to argue with the people who hosted the party that paid me to host it. You know, it was just unbearable for him to see me in that capacity, shining and winning it, plus getting paid. And, you know, his motor was to act out of his female emotions. So a lot of times dudes act crazy just because they're not getting enough attention, or they don't feel that the light ain't on them, so they try to Calvin, you know, I looked at the nigga like a damn fool, and eventually they calmed the nigga down, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, that's what he wanted. He wanted to take the focus off me and put the focus on him. So you got people that do that too, so you got to be very sharp and know when people's trying to, you know, make a grandstand. Sometimes, you know, if you just casually remove yourself from the room and just totally avoid the situation, then they won't be able to get their shine. But you got to be sharp too. You got to know when they're trying to bust a move on you like that.
Yeah.
You got to know when, you know, people really just trying to, hey man, be as tension stealers. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And when you realize that, the only way to curtail that or cut it off is to just casually move yourself from the premise, you know, and then they're going to be sitting up there looking like a fool. But if you engage and if you allow your emotions to get caught up, and you don't use your intelligence, and then that person will ultimately win. Because as I said, when two fools argue from a distance, a wise man don't know who's the fool. Like, because you argue with a fool, you obviously must be a fool too.
Yeah, like you said, because you're engaged.
Yeah, so when you know people talk crazy, man, if it don't affect your bottom line, if it don't deal with your financial situations, you know what I'm saying, your financial gains, then the best thing to do, man, is just, you know, totally just avoid the situation. You know, that'll help a lot. Because, you know, I mean, people going to talk about you. People going to hate on you. People going to copy you. People going to want what you got. You know, ain't nothing you can do about that. You just have to live with it. You know what I mean? And sometimes, you know, step aside. You know, let that bullshit lie.
Too cool to come 24/7.